Hey guys, today we're going to talk about the differences between a bull guard or a brush guard versus a push bumper. Adding accessories to the front of a vehicle like a bull guard, brush guard, push bar is always popular. Now, they're not always equal or the same. So we're going to discuss the typical differences that we see on brush guards like this one versus actual push bars. Now, at first glance, you might think that they're relatively the same, but they're not. There's a big reason why they are advertised as push bumpers versus a brush guard. Now, the brush guards are much smaller, and if you're looking for something more low-key and a good place to mount lights, this might be right for you. And it also keeps debris off the front of the vehicle. If you are going through the brush and you don't want those branches and everything smacking the bumper too much, but let's be realistic, if you're off-roading, you're going to scratch your vehicle. So the problem that I have with these particular pieces are, you can see that this one is right up into the bumper, it's starting to rust. This is plastic, this is steel, but it's rubbing right into the bumper. Why is that? So when we look underneath, you can see it's adjustable here. So it looks like they hit an obstacle, and now it's tweaked it on the adjustability part. Also, look how long the bracket goes up. So even if you load straight into it, you're not loading into the frame, you're cantilevering off of this bracket. Now, it is angled steel, so that helps give it strength. But at the end of the day, I've seen it way too many times where these things are pushed into the bumper and not doing what people think that they're supposed to do. But they're not marketed that way, it's just a perception people think that they're stronger than they actually are. You know, down here is great for styling, but I would not rely on this hitting an obstacle. That's what your skid plates are for. And if you hit this on an obstacle, which is might what have happened, and it pushes, it's just gonna push right into your bumper and damage your expensive OEM bumper. What they are really good for though is also, besides styling, is mounting lights if you choose to. That way you're not drilling holes or modifying your bumper. And they are big pieces of steel that are hollow inside, so it's easy to run wire inside of it. You can see here that there's little knockouts here, so they're expecting you to run wiring inside of it. Okay, what about an actual push bumper? So this is what I like about these guys. You can get them in versions like this that just cover the grille, or you can get it on a full version that covers the headlight. I prefer this kind of styling similar to the brush guard. Nice and simple, does look intimidating, it's beefy. But here's the big difference with this thing. Ones like this, this is a Go Rhino one, you see there's a bracket that goes in here into the bumper bolt. That helps support the weight. If you push against something, it's not going to just cantilever, it's going to help load the forces into there. Also down here, it mounts straight to the same area where the tow hooks are that mounts the frame. So this is a really strong piece. A lot of these bull bars, you go up to them and they feel flimsy, especially the aluminum versions. The other thing with a lot of push bars, this is a Go Rhino version, it actually has a step. So the nice thing is I grab one here, put my foot down here, I can get up and wash the hood, service the engine, whatever. It also has a place to mount lights. It's a C channel, so it's easy to run wires and everything through it as well. Now we've gone the extra mile, these are bolted together, we've gone ahead and welded it all together to make it a stronger piece. Now I will say this, this is not a ram bar, this is a push bar. You go up to the obstacle, maybe it's a vehicle that needs to be moved. You go up to it gently, have it get rest against here, that's what these rubber pieces are here for, and you push it gently. If you ram into a vehicle at a significant speed, yes, it'll take the grunt of the force, but it will be mangled. It is not invincible. It's not one of those big cow catchers that you see on the front of a semi-truck, and even those things will get damaged. So hopefully, guys, that helps you distinguish between the two. Neither are going to be perfect. They both have their pros and cons. Ones like this, like a push bar like this with heavier gauge steel, is going to typically going to cost more, and it typically has more engineering behind it because ones like this is designed specifically only for this truck. You could adapt it to another truck would be difficult. While a lot of those bull bars or brush guards are more of a universal design, and then just the brackets change depending on the application. So let me know, guys, do you run a brush guard like this, or do you run a push bar like that? And tell me why. I'd like to know.